Good evening, folks, and welcome to episode 77, all the sevens of The Organist Entertains, brought to you from here in Bellshill Central Parish Church. Our first hymn tonight is a hymn of the season, the harvest season. We plough the fields and scatter the good seed on the land, but it is fed and watered by God's almighty hand. That's the words of the first portion of the first verse. The words are by Matthias Claudius, translated into English by Jane Montgomery Campbell. The tune is, of course, Wir pflügen. Melody by Johann Schultz and harmonised by John Dykes. This hymn is a request of Bellshill Central Choir member Elspeth Dornan. And it's very appropriate because churches around the country, around the world, in fact, are celebrating the gift of the harvest over these coming weeks. And we at Bellshill Central are having our first harvest service in almost 2 years. A mini version of it, because we would normally have a lovely ploughman's lunch in the hall. However, we are going to be able to sing some wonderful harvest hymns, perhaps including We Plough the Fields and Scatter. So thank you, Elspeth, for requesting this wonderful hymn of the season, We Plough the Fields and Scatter.
Thank you.
Our next hymn choice tonight comes from Bellshill Choir member and member of our church, Alexa Walker. And sorry, Alexa, that it's taken a couple of weeks to get there, but we generally always do, so worry not. It's the hymn, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross. Of course, words by Isaac Watts. But the tune that Alexa has requested is Morte Christi by Emrys Jones. Of course, those people who enjoy and listen to male voice choirs, you're going to know this tune. It's a wonderful arrangement which fits these words just so perfectly. Each verse with its own introduction or interlude before we get to the final glorious verse. So thank you, Alexa, for requesting When I Survey the Wondrous Cross to the wonderful tune of Morte Christi.
Thank you.
Our next hymn choice tonight comes from the Cook household. Stan and June Cook have requested the wonderful hymn by Stuart Townend, In Christ Alone. It's one of those hymns, as I've said very often on the Organist Entertains, which I think will be around in a couple of hundred years' times. It's a wonderful hymn of faith. It's a wonderful hymn which reminds us of the resurrection on which our faith is founded on. I hope that you enjoy hearing it tonight. When we have this as a hymn at Bellshill Central, it all alternates between being played on the piano and the organ, and it works equally as well on either. And I hope that you enjoy hearing the rousing last verse, with most of the stops pulled, blowing away some of the cobwebs, dare I say it, here in church. However, the tones and colours telling the story of the words that we're going to see and hear and sing. Thank you, Stan and June, for requesting In Christ Alone. Thank you. Our next hymn tonight is the choice of fellow organist Tony Newnham. And before I introduce your hymn, I just want to say thank you once more for taking part in last week's episode. It was wonderful to hear you and see you, and of course, see and hear you playing the organ. The comments which people made were very, very generous. They were just simply pleased to see and hear from you. We've heard your hymn requests over the last year, and we've enjoyed chatting in the YouTube chat, but it really was nice to actually see you. And thank you for such a wonderful lyrical interpretation of Noel Rothstorn's Prelude on Slain, Be Thou My Vision. But this week, we have a request from you. What kind of love is this? Music and words by Bryn and Sally Haworth. The words are, what kind of love is this that gave itself for me? I am the guilty one, yet I go free. What kind of love is this? A love I've never known. I didn't even know his name. What kind of love is this? Of course, that's the love of the Lord Jesus, and that is the story, the meaning of this hymn, that the ultimate sacrifice was given, all for the love of humankind. This is a gentler hymn, and it allows us to show you some of the softer and gentler stops on the organ behind me, and it allows you to hear our lovely oboe stop as a solo, and I think it's verse one. Thank you, Tony, for requesting this lovely hymn. What kind of love is this?
Thank you.
Well, it wouldn't be The Organist Entertains without a regular request from Ed Anderson in South Africa. Tonight we have the hymn, My Jesus, I Love Thee, I Know Thou Art Mine, to the tune of the same title, My Jesus, I Love Thee. It's taken from Ed's Methodist hymnal in South Africa, and the words are by J.H. Duffel of 1864, and the tune is marked as unknown. I know that Sheila Miller is going to enjoy this hymn because it delves into hymns from the Methodist hymnals of days gone by. My Jesus, I love thee, I know thou art mine. For thee all the pleasures of sin I resign. My gracious Redeemer, my Saviour art thou. If ever I loved thee, if ever I loved thee, if ever I loved thee, my Jesus, 'tis now. Thank you, Ed, for introducing us to this wonderful hymn from the Methodist hymnal. My Jesus, I love thee, I know thou art mine.
Thank you.
Well, we have an organ piece now, but it's a requested organ piece, and it has been requested by Thelma Anderson, wife of Ed, both of whom are organists in South Africa. The piece that Thelma has requested is "O for the Wings of a Dove," which is from the anthem "Hear My Prayer," an anthem for solo, either a lady solo or a boy soprano solo, and choir, full soprano, alto, tenor and bass. "Hear my prayer, O God, incline thine ear," is how the anthem starts. But it moves into the wonderful text of "Oh, for the wings of a dove." And of course, the music by Felix Mendelssohn is just divine. The organ behind us has some wonderful colours in its stop selection. And I use our 4-foot harmonic flute to begin with, used and accompanied by our wonderful stopped flute on the swell organ. It grows in volume and then it dies off again. But don't worry, it doesn't become overly loud. It is, after all, a reflective, wonderful organ piece. Thank you, Thelma, for requesting "O for the Wings of a Dove." Our next two hymns come from Lorna Patterson, friend of the Organist Entertains, who watches along with her husband Ian. Lorna and Ian, and Ian being a retired Church of Scotland parish minister, have a love of the Psalms. And we included one of Lorna's Psalms the other week, Howard. This week, we have two. The first is to the tune Bon Accord, and that is music found in the Scottish Psalter of 1625. And it's set to Psalm 95. O come and let us to the Lord, in songs our voices raise. It's one of these delightful Scottish psalm tunes, which we unfortunately don't really sing nowadays. It was a staple of the church in Scotland when we had proper four-part choirs, where, for example, with Joyful Noise Let Us the Rock, really did come into its own, starting with the tenors, adding the basses, adding the altos, and then adding the sopranos. Unfortunately, in days where choir numbers are not what they once were, and part singers, we don't really have the numbers that we once did, delightful hymns to tunes such as Bon Accord, really, we don't choose any longer. So it's wonderful to hear from Lorna and Ian requesting tunes such as this, that we get to hear them once more. So thank you, Lorna and Ian, for the first of your two psalm requests. Psalm 95, O come and let us to the Lord, to the psalm tune, Bon Accord. Psalm 43, O send thy light forth and thy truth. Another staple of the church in Scotland. In our church hymnals, it's set to two tunes, the first being Martyrs. And that is a melody from the Scottish Psalter of 1615. However, O send thy light forth and thy truth conjures up for me, and probably most of you, one tune. And it's not Martyrs. It's the wonderful extended psalm tune of Invocation by Robert Archibald Smith. Psalm 43 is taken from the Scottish Psalter of 1929 in our hymn books. And I am sure that you will have heard choirs such as the Phoenix or recordings of the former Orpheus Choir singing this. The music means that we sing two verses of the verses 3 to 5 of the psalm. However, it's an extended version of it. And it's, again, one of these hymns, psalms, that we don't sing all that often. And to be fair, I think it would confuse the living daylights out of many congregations if it were placed on the praise list. It's got a delightful part towards the end where we have sopranos and altos singing together before the tenors and basses join in. And then we have another part at the end, which is where the extended bit comes from. For my harp, my harp, my harp I will employ. And again, it has the sopranos and altos, then the tenors, and then the basses. So get your hymn books out. It's in CH4, or Hymns of Glory, Songs of Praise, one in the same book, at number 35, if you're wanting to sing along and look at the music. Thank you, Lorna, for requesting such a wonderful psalm, Psalm 43. O send thy light forth to the wonderful psalm tune of Invocation.
Thank you.
Our next choice tonight comes from our friend who lives in Glenmavis. That would be our friend Morag MacLeod. And I know that you tune in each week and you take part and enjoy our selection of hymns and musical requests. You have chosen your favourite hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. It's a hymn which features very, very frequently in our Organist Entertains, so I think it must be pushing Love Divine or Love's Excelling out of that pole position, perhaps, of being the most requested hymn in the Organist Entertains. I've played it numerous times, and I try and play it differently each time. So tonight's rendition of What a Friend We Have in Jesus, hopefully, is a little bit more gentler and relaxed, showing you more of the softer tones of our organs, stops and colours and registrations. Thank you, Morag, for tuning in so faithfully each week, and thank you for requesting your hymn tonight, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Tonight we've already heard one of our organ voluntaries because it was requested by Thelma. However, I have come across two lovely little voluntaries which we are going to include this evening. Both of them are for manuals only, which means my feet get a rest. The first is a delightful item called Pastoral, and it is by Wesley. It shows off the wonderful and lovely flute stops on the organ. I do hope that you enjoy this lull in proceedings in between our hymn choices tonight. Pastoral by Wesley. Well, now we have a hymn which is a favourite of many. It's a hymn which I know is a favourite of Emma Smith, Peggy Walker, Zandra Swan, and many more. Now, perhaps these individuals may already have guessed what the hymn choice is. It's The Pescadores, that's the name of the tune. And the hymn, of course, is Lord, You Have Come to the Seashore. It's a hymn which I know lots of people love. It's one of those hymns which crosses many different denominations, and that is the wonderful gift that is music. It knows no divides. It crosses all boundaries, and it encapsulates everybody. Lord, You Have Come to the Seashore is one such hymn. I always laugh and have a little chuckle to myself if I choose, the minister chooses, or it's requested and the organist entertains, because it's a hymn with a little bugbear of mine. I'll get my hymn book, and I'll show you what I mean. In the hymn book, CH4, it's found at 532, if memory, yes, memory does serve correctly this evening. And there we go. Hopefully you can see that. However, the music which is on the left-hand side is only for the verse. We then have four verses. And then you've got to turn the page for a whole page of music, followed by one line, such as this. Which means you'll see me playing it with two hymn books open so that I don't have to turn the page. So this is a request to when the Church of Scotland next gets round to doing a hymn book, if I have got nothing to do with it. Please cut out silly page turns. For example, Lord, you have come to the seashore. And while I'm at it, another one is, let us build a house, all are welcome. It's laid out in the same way. And that is just a bugbear of this organist. However, this is a favourite hymn of Emma, Peggy and Zandra. Lord, you have come to the seashore. Thank you. Our last organ prelude is Aria in G major, and it's by the composer Petrus Papin. Again, this is for manuals only. The feet get a little rest for this one. And it's another delightful, lyrical, and very animated piece of music. It shows off the wonderful flute stops again on our organ. And this particular piece of music would not be out of place in an old English sounding organ back in the earlier centuries before Romanticism took over our organs and made things sound even fuller and richer than what they once were. I do hope that you enjoy this short but nonetheless delightful organ voluntary, Aria in G major by Petrus Papin. We are now approaching the end of tonight's episode 77, and we now have the last three hymn requests. The first in our last section comes from the friend of Bellshill Central, the organist entertains, and a participant in our church's virtual choir during lockdown, Anne White, who lives over in Ireland. Anne has been a singer all of her days, so it is no surprise in one of her hymn choices. My life flows on in endless song, above earth's lamentation. I catch the sweet, though far off, hymn that hails a new creation. The chorus ending in the line, how can I keep from singing? The tune is of an American traditional melody, and it's been arranged and adapted by the composers of Common Ground in 1998. The words themselves are by Robert Lowry and Doris Plain. How can I keep from singing? Now, Anne, I know that you enjoy singing along with the organist entertains, and I do hope that your neighbours have been full warned that you actually have a hymn choice tonight and that you are going to be singing like a linty. I think that's the phrase. Enjoy your hymn, Anne. Thank you for the list which you've sent, and we'll get through them in the next couple of weeks. And thank you for reminding us, how can we keep from singing? Thank you. Our penultimate hymn request tonight comes from Bellshill Central Choir member Sheena McEwen. It's the hymn, God Sent His Son, They Called Him Jesus, or Because He Lives. It's a hymn which I know many, many people like singing. It's one of those hymns with a kind of Redemption Hall, Moody and Sankey feel to it, although it's not as old as it may seem. It's written by the Gaither family. It's a hymn we often sing here at Bellshill Central when we have a baptism, because it's got a wonderfully delightful, picture-creating verse in it. How sweet to hold a newborn baby. And we often sing that, as I say, when we have a baptism of an infant here at Bellshill Central. I know it's a favourite hymn also of Sharon Malone, whose children, Bella and Samuel, were christened here in church over the last few years. And it's a custom here at Bellshill Central that when we hold a baptism service, we ask the baptismal party, whether that be mum and dad, aunts and uncles, granny and grandpas, if they have a favourite hymn that we could incorporate into the portion in the service which contains the baptism itself. So that could be the first hymn, or it could be the hymn post-baptism, so to speak. And I'm sure that Sharon requested God Sent His Son at either Bella or Samuel's christening service. So thank you, Sheena, for requesting a hymn which I know is much loved by many. God Sent His Son, They Called Him Jesus.
Thank you.
Well, we have now reached the final hymn tonight, and it is a hymn requested by me. I think it's only fair that every now and again the organist gets to choose something. And it came to me because of how we started proceedings this evening. We started with a harvest hymn, and we're going to finish with a harvest hymn. Can anyone guess what it might be? There are two great harvest hymns, and we've already had one, so it can't be anything else other than Come, You Thankful People Come. Raise the song of Harvest Home. And this coming Sunday at Bellshill Central, we are having our mini harvest service, and it may well be on the praise list. The words are by Henry Alford, and the tune, of course, is St. George's Windsor, with the music written by George Elvey. And like our opening hymn tonight, much to the shock and horror of some of our part singers, I do venture back into the delightful book of 400 Last Verses by Noel Rosethorne. I think I've been quite generous in only venturing into it twice tonight with our first and last hymns. The organ here at Bellshill Central has 16 stops. And to look at it on paper, it doesn't look like it packs the punch that it actually does. So you will hear the wonderful full swell, the diapason chorus with the reeds on top for the start and finish of Come, You Thankful People Come. And I do hope that you enjoy hearing this wonderful harvest hymn of praise.
Thank you.
Well, folks, thank you for tuning in and sticking with us for episode 77 in the Organist Entertains series. We definitely have enjoyed a wealth of different styles, genres, modern, a little bit more traditional types of hymns and songs tonight. And that is what music does. As I've said earlier, music knows no boundaries. It crosses all divides. It brings people together. And it also shows us the different types of music that everybody loves. So I do hope that you've enjoyed the requests that we've had this evening. Episode 78 will come to you, and I again request your input. Send me your hymn requests. Tell me why it's your request, or like Tony did a few weeks ago, he sent in a video introducing his hymn and saying why Be Thou My Vision, as it was for Tony's request, was important to him. If there are any musicians who are tuning in, Ed, Thelma, Tony again, John up in Fort William, if you would like to take part by sending me a video of you playing, then that would be wonderful. It lets us see and hear someone else other than this on a Wednesday night. As always, if you wish to make a donation to Bellshill Central Parish Church, there is a link in the box below which will take you to the Church of Scotland donation page, and it allows you to make a safe and secure donation to the work of the church here in Bellshill. If you would like to come and visit us now that we are open for public worship on Sunday mornings, it would be great to see you. I know that a couple of you have said that once restrictions, etc., are all lifted, that you're going to come along and enjoy singing along with the organ that you've seen and heard on your phone, television, or computer screens over the last 18 months, and that would be really, really good to see you in the flesh. So, all things said and done, thank you for tuning in with episode 77. Stay safe. Coronavirus hasn't gone away. Keep well and good night, and we'll see you next week.